I'll be showing 5 new AI features in Teams for Education. These are free and available for all educators. This includes rubric creation, assignment instructions, classwork module creation, and a whole lot more. So let's get started.
The first new feature is AI assignment instructions generation. I'm an educator signed into Teams, and I'm going to choose create at the bottom, and then I'll choose new assignment. Here's the assignment form. Let's give it a quick title. A science project on photosynthesis, and we'll give some basic instructions. Science project on how photosynthesis works, some pretty lame instructions, but with the power of AI right here, I've got a bunch of options. Over on the right for settings, if I click here, you can set the grade level, or you can choose the language as well, and I'll show language a little bit later. Maybe I want to set this to 6th grade right here, and now I can go click add detail. Let's see what happens. So AI is generating. If I want to stop, I can click there. Okay, a nice science project. Introduction, material, procedures, and I can choose to keep this, I can regenerate, I can also give a little AI thumbs up or down. This sends data back to Microsoft to say, hey, this was good, or no, that wasn't very good. In this case, I'll choose keep it. But I can go back and have other options. So I can do things like clarify concepts, emphasize key concepts. You know what, I want to emphasize some key concepts here. Let's click that and see what happens. There goes AI. Oh, it's bolding certain concepts like this. All right, so now I've got lots of bold words, but you know, maybe I don't like that. I'm gonna say, you know, let's cancel that one. And in this case, I can go back and say, I wanna add learning objectives. And it's quickly added some learning objectives here. I'll choose to keep it. And you can explore all the other options, but I'm gonna show one of my favorites right here. I'm gonna add sparkle, add some emojis, make it a little more fun. Okay, a little emojis added, my little sparkle. I will choose to keep it. Now the last thing I'm gonna show is great for different languages. So I'm gonna click here. I can choose to set a language. Maybe I wanna have this go all in Norwegian. We'll choose Norwegian Bokmål right here. And now instead, I'm gonna say add detail. Look at that, it's added all the detail, but in this case, everything is in Norwegian. So I will choose to keep that. The second new feature is AI-generated rubrics. So I've got my photosynthesis project here. I'll go and click add rubric. Now you can create a rubric from scratch that's existed. You can upload one, but in this case, I'm gonna choose to create a rubric using AI. So we'll give it a title, set your language, we'll keep it at English, and what would you like this rubric to evaluate? Evaluate students on the quality and detail of this photosynthesis project. Pretty simple, hit next. What's the grade level? You have a bunch of choices right here. I'm gonna leave it at grade 6. The rubric scale, you've got a couple of options here, excellent, fair, poor, meet standards, etc. What criteria will this rubric evaluate? Now you can enter your own, but AI also suggests a few for you. So you can have clarity of explanation, quality of visual representation, research and understanding of photosynthesis. You can add all, you could add new criteria, but we'll just leave it right here at these 3. And I'll choose create rubric using AI. So AI is now going to fill out a draft of my rubric really quickly. Okay, here you go. It has excellent, good, fair, and poor. You can modify rubric using AI. You could regenerate. Again, the thumbs up and thumbs down. If I wanted to add new criteria here, I can do that. And I can say fill out descriptions using AI. So criteria, application to the real world, and hit done. So now AI is gonna generate a new line right here and how it works with the real world or not. So really simple to do. And if I wanna modify the rubric using AI, I can go back, I can change grades, I can change languages, what do you want it to evaluate? You could even say concise versus expanded. So a lot of options. This is really a big time saver for educators. The third new feature is using AI to create classwork modules. I'm an educator here, and I'm gonna switch to Classwork to create some content and curricula for my class. Down at the bottom, I'll click Add Module. And there's a new option, Module Ideas Using AI. I'll choose this. Now, very simple format. I'm gonna give it a subject. Chemistry, I'll choose the grade level. I can go everywhere from kindergarten all the way up to university, grade 8, grade 9. I'll choose grade 9. And then what language would you like this in? We have many different options. And then I'll click Next. Now, what do you want students to know or be able to know upon completing the class? So I'm gonna add this right here, I'm gonna paste. And by the end of the semester, students will have an intro to chemistry, etc. give some details. Also, just for fun, please add an emoji at the beginning of each module name that reflects the module content. Then you can choose how many modules do you want. So I can go up and down. We'll make this 7. And now I'll choose draft modules in the lower right. Okay, AI is going to draft up some modules for me. All right, here we go. I have my different modules. Looks like there are 7 of them. There's an emoji in front of each one, which makes it kind of fun. Now what's nice is I can modify these. I can regenerate. Also right here, I can go in directly to each module. So let's say I want to go into Intro to Chemistry and choose Edit. I can go and change this right here. I can choose Adjust, so I can make bulleted list instead of a paragraph. I can make it more concise versus expanded. I could regenerate right here. And you can do that with any module. And I'm going to show a different way to regenerate all of them. So this is the one by one way. I just click on the little edit pencil here. But I'm going to go up to Modify Modules. And you get the same options, but this is across all of them. So I will choose bulleted list, and I'm going to make it more concise. And then I'll choose to update all the modules. Okay, here we go. Look at that. Now it's more concise, just in a bulleted list. I've got all my 7 modules ready to go. Also, you can say, hey, did I like this or not? Was that good creation with AI or bad? This gives us great feedback for the team. So give it a thumbs up or down if you want. And then I'm going to go at the bottom right and say add draft modules. And there we go. It's getting them ready. And there we are. The 7 modules for my chemistry classwork set ready to go. The fourth new feature is reading progress passage generation using AI. Reading Progress is our free reading fluency tool. It's built into Microsoft Teams. It's one of our learning accelerators right here. And I'm not going to do a deep dive into all of Reading Progress. There's a link in the description if you want to learn more about that. I'm going to show the latest AI passage generation feature. So I'll click Learning Accelerators, and then I'm going to choose Reading Progress. You're going to see 3 buttons here, and the one in the middle is new. Historically, I could browse the sample library to choose a passage. I could import my own Word or PDF document. I could pull from Class Notebook or Teams or upload. But many educators want to be able to use a little help in generating their own tailored passages and personalized. I'll choose Generate Reading Passage. Now here's the dialogue. I can choose a topic, anything from arts to animals to geography, health, sports. We'll choose animals. You can choose the length of the passage. Maybe I want this to be 200 words. The age range, lots of different options. We're going to have an age range of 9. And you can choose a language. We've got many different languages that we support. I will choose English. The other nice thing is that you can pull in the challenging words from your class. So if you've used Reading Progress, we know from our AI what words the students struggled with when reading out loud. And we'll pull in the most challenging words already right here for you to select. So maybe I want to uncheck this one and uncheck that one. And I'd like to have these 3 words put into this AI-generated passage. So I'm going to click Generate Reading Passage. So very quickly, it generated a passage about animals. The other nice thing is I can choose complexity. I can make it a little more complex or a little less complex. So, you know, I want to make this slightly more complicated. I'll click the complexity up, and it's going to regenerate that passage and make it just a little bit harder. So there we go. I could go back down again, back to where I was before, or I could say, you know, I want to make it a little bit less complex and hit the down arrow. So now my passage is ready to go. I'll click Use Passage, and now I have a passage right there in Reading Progress, ready to go and assigned to my students. Reading Progress passage generation has globally rolled out and is available to every educator on Earth today. The fifth new feature is comprehension question generation using AI in Reading Progress. I have my passage here as an educator, and this pane on the right gives me all my options. We've had the option for adding comprehension questions right here, but now when I turn this on to yes, I can choose to generate questions with AI. So I can add my own manually, or I can click generate questions. So let's click this, and it's going to ask me how many questions would I like to generate. I'm going to say I want 4 questions, and I'll hit next. Now AI is going to analyze the passage over here on the left, and using forms technology, it's going to generate a set of questions. So here we go. It generates some questions. It highlights what's the correct answer. I can scroll down, and there's a couple more questions. And it's a mix of true, false, multiple choice, or fill in the blank. And what's nice is you can go and edit and change these. So I might want to change this question. Maybe I want to move it down in the list. I can do that, just like in forms. Maybe I want to delete this question. So you can choose to do whatever you want. And when you're done, you can click in the lower right, expand the pane so you can get back into here if you want to change anything else. And now you just hit next and your assignment and reading progress is ready to go.